And Carly, we've got a gorgeous day on the way. That's actually the moon, not the sun. But let me get to our day planner for you. We are right now in the upper 40s. We will be in the 50s before long. It's really not going to take long to warm up today. The air above us is even warmer than it was yesterday. As a result, high temperatures a couple of degrees warmer than yesterday. So look at that. Nothing but sunshine all day long. And then tonight, the evening hours look equally comfortable. 7 o'clock tonight, we've got a matching 70 down to 64 at 9 o'clock under starry skies with a beautiful moon out there at 9 o'clock. And look at this sunrise. The sun just kissing the horizon there. Just posted this on my Facebook page, Sally Showman Coin. If you want to steal it and share it with your friends, you are welcome to. Here we go to Vancouver. Equally beautiful there. And temperatures in the 40s. In fact, just about all of us are in the 40s this morning, even upper 40s in Westland, 47 degrees there. Out toward Gresham, 44 degrees. So we're quite a bit warmer than we were at this point yesterday. We've got 30s and 40s out along the coast. The further south you go along the coast, the more clouds we're seeing this morning, but you'll get some sunshine this afternoon too. I-5 corridor, sunny and 40s. We have some high clouds east of the Cascades and temperatures in the 30s and the 40s. 3D Pinpoint Doppler shows the clear conditions through the I-5 corridor, and there are those high clouds, but that makes for an even more beautiful sunrise. So I'm kind of thankful for those today. Just a little change in pace is nice. We've been spoiled with such nice weather, and the reason for it, high pressure off in the Pacific, sending all the storms well to the north. Some of those clouds riding right over the top of the ridge, and that's why we're seeing some of those high clouds east of the mountains today. How about rain and cloud cast? Well, a few high clouds drifting through today. That ought to do it. Less wind today than yesterday. Tomorrow morning, 6 a.m., you'll notice we've got more clouds along the coast. So the onshore flow returns, which means the ocean air makes it up to the coast range but doesn't make it inland until Saturday. More clouds on Saturday and then a few light sprinkles on Sunday. You can see they're making their way from north to south by early on Sunday morning. And then we have rain from time to time until Monday, and then we dry out again. So we'll get to that in your 7-day forecast. In our skies this morning, I had to mention it because if you were up early, you noticed it. I know you did. I was wondering if it was the moon or the sun. It was so bright. We have the full pink moon. It set this morning at 5:54. It'll still be very full tonight. Not 100% full, but really bright again tonight. So look for it. 8:31 is when it rises over the Cascades. In fact, I caught a time lapse of it setting over the West Hills. And it's not pink. The reason it's called the full pink moon is because it's named after the first flowers of spring. And so each month, the full moon has a different name. Kind of fun trivia for you. 76 degrees the high in Portland. Another gorgeous day, sunny and warm. The west side of town in the mid to upper 70s. Remember, the warmest day of the year so far has been 77 degrees. So if we get beyond that, it'll be the warmest day so far of 2013 in Portland. Out at the coast, slightly cooler than yesterday. Clouds increasing from the south. Through the I-5 corridor, temperatures in the 70s with lots of sunshine. Some of those high clouds east of the mountains today, but otherwise sunny skies and beautiful weather. Friday, equally gorgeous, 69 on Saturday. So clouds increasing, but still above average. Light shower Sunday, morning rain Monday, and then we're drying out and warming up again toward the middle part of next week. Yeah.